You are listening to Daily Bread Devotions with Father Eustace Yame, a Salesian of Don Bosco. Your word, Lord, is a lamp for my steps. Stay tuned.
This is my daily bread. This is my daily bread. Your very word, spoken to me.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
It is Friday, the 5th of August, 2022, 18th week in ordinary time, and we celebrate today the dedication of one of the four most illustrious basilicas of Rome, the Basilica of St. Mary Major. According to tradition, the Virgin Mary appeared in a dream of two faithful Roman Christians, as well as to Pope Liberius, 352 to 366, asking that a church be built in her honor on the site where snow would fall on the night of August 4th to 5th. Pope Liberius traced the outlines of the church in the snow, and the first basilica was built on that site. It was completed about a century later by Pope Sixtus III, 432 to 440, after the Council of Ephesus in 431, during which Mary was declared to be the Mother of God. Participating in the proclamation of the Word of God for today are the following Daily Bread members. Julia Gwala, who celebrates her birthday tomorrow, from Nairobi, Kenya, takes for us the first reading. Raymond Zinara, who celebrates his birthday today, from Rua, Zimbabwe, takes for us the responsorial psalm. And proclaiming the gospel is Father Delfinos Felician, a Salesian of Don Bosco, working as a rector of Don Bosco College in Moshi, Tanzania, as he celebrates his birthday today. Let us pray. Draw near to your servants, O Lord, and answer their prayers with unceasing kindness, that for those who glory in you as their creator and guide, you may restore what you have created and keep safe what you have restored. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen.
First reading. Woe to the bloody city. A reading from the book of Prophet Nahum. Nahum chapter 1 verse 15. Chapter 2, verse 2, chapter 3, verse 1 to 3, and verse 6 to 7. Behold, on the mountains of the feet of him who brings good tidings, who proclaims peace, keep your feasts, O Judah, fulfill your vows, for never again shall the wicked come against you. He is utterly cut off. For the Lord is restoring the majesty of Jacob, as the majesty of Israel. For plunderers have stripped them and ruined their branches. Woe to the bloody city, all full of lies and booty. No end to the plunder, the crack of whip and rumble of wheel. Galloping horse are bounding chariot, horsemen charging, flashing sword and glittering spear. Host of slain, heaps of corpses, dead bodies without end. They stumble over the bodies. I will throw filth at you and treat you with contempt and make you an object of scorn. And all who look on you will shrink from you and say, wasted is Nineveh. Who will mourn over her? Whence shall I seek comforters for her? The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Response of Psalm, Deuteronomy 32, verses 35 CD, 36 AB. 39 A, B, C, D, and 41. And the response is taken from Deuteronomy 32, verse 39. And the response is, I kill and I make alive.
I kill and I make alive.
For the day of their calamity is at hand, and their doom comes swiftly. For the Lord will vindicate his people and have compassion on his
I kill and I make alive.
See now that I, even I, am he, and there is no God besides me. I kill and I make alive. I wound.
I kill and I make alive.
If I sharpened my glittery sword, and my hand takes hold on judgment, I will take vengeance on my adversaries, and I will repay those who hate me.
I kill and I make alive.
What shall a man give in return for his life? The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Matthew chapter 16, verse 24-28. At that time, Jesus told his disciples, "If any man would come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whoever would save his life will lose it, and whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. For what will it profit a man if he gains the whole world and forfeits his life? Or what shall a man give in return for his life? For the Son of Man is to come with his angels in the glory of his Father, and then he will repay every man for what he has done. Truly I say to you, there are some standing here who will not taste death before they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
We finished the book of Jeremiah yesterday. Today we are looking at Nahum, and Nahum is only for today. It is good for us to look at the background of this prophet Nahum. We have to understand, for almost three centuries, the Assyrians had dominated the world of the time, meaning the Near East, from east of the Tigris River to the southern border of Egypt. No people of the ancient world were more feared or more hated than the Assyrians. The people of Israel had felt the weight of their wrath and their cruelty. In 722 BC, the Assyrians conquered the northern kingdom of Israel and had forced its inhabitants into an exile from which they never recovered. They never returned. Towards the year 700, under the Assyrian commander and later king Sennacherib, they had invaded Judah, devastated its cities. They laid siege to Jerusalem. The holy city was saved at that time by the intervention of God. It's only God who could do it. But Judah became in effect a subject state of the Assyrian Empire. Now the political situation began to change about 630 BC with the death of the last Assyrian king, Ashurbanipal. Under combined attacks from the Medes in the northeast and the Babylonians in the south, the old Assyrian capital of Ashur fell in 614 BC. The royal capital, Nineveh, was captured and destroyed in 612, and the Assyrian Empire came to an end, to the universal rejoicing of its many victims. And this is the message that Nahum is bringing. It is long after the fall of Nineveh, the Assyrian capital. And he brings this news: "Behold, upon the mountains the feet of him who brings good news, who publishes peace. Keep your feasts, O Judah, fulfill your vows, for never again shall be the worthless pass through you." Is utterly cut off. Assyria, with its great power, is no more. Utterly cut off. Wasted is Nineveh. Who will grieve for her? Where shall I seek comforters for her? End of Nineveh. End of a great power. We have seen many great powers that have rejoiced in being great, in being oppressors, coming to an end. I don't know what is oppressing you right now. I don't know what you might be experiencing right now that makes you feel under chain. Those chains are going to be broken. They are not forever. That oppression is not forever. It's just for a while. Our God has ended powers that thought would never come to an end. They have ended. Assyria, Nineveh, where is it? It's nowhere to be seen. So I tell you, whatever may be oppressive, whichever government may be oppressive, it is just for a while. The gospel passage of today is in the context of the revelation of Christ. Christ has revealed himself, and he now tells his disciples that they have to know that following him is not an easy thing. They have to learn to humble themselves. Many of them were ambitious. They thought Jesus was going to establish some kingdom here on earth, and they were going to get positions, they were going to be ministers, and so they were trying to show their pride that they were special. No, it's not like that. Following Christ means being in a position to humble yourself and become sacrificial. It is not for the selfish. It is not for those who want to gain. It is for those who want others to gain through them. That's what the word wants to tell us. If anyone would come after me, let him deny himself and take up his cross and follow me. For whoever would save his life will lose it. But whoever loses his life for my sake will find it. Truly I say to you, there are some standing here who will not taste death until they see the Son of Man coming in his kingdom. Who are those who are not going to taste death? Those who are not going to taste death are those who have learned to sacrifice themselves. Those who sacrifice themselves for others never die. They remain forever because their names are going to be mentioned by generation after generation. We give glory to the Father and to the Son and to the Holy Spirit.
As it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Blessed Friday to you.
Thanks be to God.
This is my daily bread. Your very word spoken to me, and I your bed.